one call that I have someone in my home that I need to have arrested?
Yes.
What time was what you're calling an arrest? What time did that take place?
It was probably after midnight, because we retrieved Casey's cell phone. My son went back to Tony Lazaro's house because the deputy did not bring anything that Casey had left behind. And part of what he brought back was Casey's items, and her cell phone was there. So it may have been even after 1 o'clock that we were out in the street and he was using Casey's cell phone, Detective Hosey was, to call all of Casey's friends.
All right, so this arrest, as you've called it, takes place after Casey's cell phone ends up back at the house?
Yes.
Because it was at Tony Lazaro's?
Casey's cell phone was at Tony Lazaro's, yes.
All right, you had said that she was in the back of the patrol car for what, quote, seemed like a long time. What does that mean?
The whole night seemed like it never ended.
What does that mean to you?
It's just like the last 2 years. It seems like it's run all into one day. So
60 seconds could have seemed like a long time?
Possibly. It seemed, I know it was longer than 60 seconds. I know it was longer than 5 minutes. But that night, you know, waiting for the sheriff's department or someone to come out seemed like forever. That's why I made 3 phone calls. It seemed like forever.
All right.
And it may have only been within a period of an hour, but it seemed like it was days at that point.
Is it your testimony that Casey Anthony was in the back of a patrol car for an hour?
It's my testimony that it seemed like it was a very long time.
So the conclusion we can draw from that testimony is you don't know how long she was there. But clearly you recall that she was uncuffed.
Yes.
And allowed to go about her business back into the house.
Yes.
Do you know what time she was uncuffed?
Again, I don't know specifically. Again, I don't know the exact time she was cuffed. I know it was after we had retrieved her cell phone.
Okay. How long until Yuri Mellett showed up after this uncuffing?
It didn't seem like that long, maybe a half hour or so.
All right, so that didn't seem like a long time. That didn't seem, it was only half an hour.
No, because once he came, things started to move a little bit faster. It's like when your life's in front of you and something is going wrong. Seeing your daughter is very traumatic, being handcuffed and taken to a car. At that moment, it seemed like an eternity.
Okay.
Even her walking down the driveway, it seemed like a long time.
All right, but it wasn't a long time until Yuri Mellett showed up, which was at 3:51 a.m.
Possibly.
Does that sound right?
Possibly, yes.
Now, you said that you saw Yuri Mellett go into a back bedroom. Is this a guest bedroom of your home?
Yes, it used to be my son's bedroom.
Okay, this is where you have a computer.
Yes.
You all were still in the house.
Yes.
The door was left open.
Yes.
This is why you could hear the conversation that took place between Detective Mellett and your daughter, Casey.
Yes, I was sitting in the reclining chair that was right in the hallway before the, you know, bedroom.
Right. Were you aware that this conversation was tape recorded?
No, I was not.
Are you aware now that it had been tape recorded?
Unless you're telling me that.
I'm asking if you're aware.
No.
Okay.
I'm not aware of that.
So I take it then you've not had an opportunity to actually listen to the recording of the conversation in this bedroom of your home between your daughter and Detective Mellett?
No, I've avoided things like that.
Did that conversation center on locating your granddaughter?
Yes.
The purpose for which You brought the police to your home?
Yes.
The conversation did not, from what you could hear, center on accusations of criminal activity by Casey Anthony?
I don't understand your question.
Was he accusing her at that point in time of doing anything to Kaylee?
Not that I didn't hear him accuse her of anything.
And after the conclusion of this conversation, the three of you sat down in the room and tried to get additional information that would assist law enforcement in finding your granddaughter. Is that correct?
Yes, we were all very cooperative, yes.
All right, including your daughter?
Absolutely.
She was freely and voluntarily giving them this information as best you could see.
Objection, I call for a conclusion on the Swiss department.
Sustained.
Did she resist them at all?
No, I mean, she didn't come running out of the room and say, I'm not talking to you, or say, I'm not speaking to you. So, not that I was aware of.
All right. Was she helping them?
I presumed that she was.
Did you hear her tell them, I don't want to have anything to do with you all?
No.
To leave her house?
No.
Did you ask them to leave?
No.
In fact, you wanted them to stay because this issue had not been resolved.
Absolutely.
Did you hear Detective Melich ask her to take him to the places where Kaylee might have been so that he could get some leads on this Zenaida person?
Yes, I know he asked her specific locations where, you know, Casey last knew that she was staying.
Did you hear him ask her to take him to places where she didn't know the exact address?
Yes.
So that they could try to resolve this situation for you and your family?
Yes.
Did she agree to do that?
She went with them. I mean,
did they drag her out of there that time?
Not that I saw, no.
Okay. So she went with them?
Mm-hmm.
Did you see her actually leave the house?
I know she left the house.
Under her own power?
That time, yes. I mean, I didn't walk her out, but yes.
All right. So then you stayed in the house, and they went wherever they went?
Mm-hmm.
Yes?
Yes.
How long were they gone?
Seemed
like a long time?
It seemed like a long time. At least an hour or so.
All right. And after however much time passed, Yuri Melich brought your daughter home.
Yes.
And she slept in her own bed.
She went to her bed.
Okay.
I mean, she went to her bedroom.
She took a shower.
That was in the morning.
Okay. So she went alone without, now all the police officers that you had summoned there are gone.
Right.
And she's there in the house with her family.
Yes.
With her cell phone, too.
Yes.
Because you said they actually gave that back to
her.
They
wanted her to have it. They wanted her to make phone calls.
All right. Because she, did you know why?
Well, I'm at that point, I believe that they were hoping that Casey would lead them to Kaylee.
All right, and I believe that you corrected your earlier testimony. You never saw Yuri Melich again until later on July 16th, correct?
Right, we spoke with him on the phone in the morning and such, and he said that they were gonna do an Amber Alert, and he instructed that he would keep us posted on what they were gonna do that day.
Did he call the house indicating that he would like Casey to come to Universal Studios?
I think my husband spoke with him, so I did not know the content of the phone call. I just know that he arranged to come back, or he had someone arranged to come back to pick Casey up.
All right.
And they did not want us to tell Casey that she was going.
So you saw then two detectives, not Yuri Melich, but John Allen and perhaps Appy Wells. They came to your house. Now, they're not in patrol car, right?
I think there was a... I thought it was the sheriff's car. I might be mistaken.
Marked with police insignia and lights and sirens?
You know, I don't think I walked outside with her. I just remember there was a car in the driveway.
Did you see these gentlemen?
Yes, Sergeant Allen came into my home. That was the first time I met him.
And he was wearing a shirt and tie?
Probably, and pants and had his badge, you know.
So you knew he was a police officer?
Yes, he introduced himself and he had his lanyard with him.
Were you present when she was asked if she would go with them to Universal Studios to assist them in finding any information that would lead them to the person who she said had Kaylee Anthony?
I do not remember the exact, I don't remember exactly what they said to her. I just remember it was very emotional for me. To send her because they had instructed us not to tell her, and they also said that she may not be coming back.
All right. Well, you didn't tell her that, right?
No, I didn't.
You didn't hear them make any statement to that effect, correct?
What, that she might not be coming back?
You didn't hear them make that statement in her presence, correct?
No.
So when they arrive, they indicate that they want to go out to Universal Studios, and from what you could see, did it appear that Casey was cooperating with them?
Yes.
Right. That she left your home with them freely?
Yes.
Under her own power?
Yes.
Did you see how she was seated?
No.
In their vehicle?
Again, I did not watch that.
Okay.
Ms. Burdick, now is a good time to take a 15-minute recess.
Okay.
Okay, we'll take a 15-minute recess at this time.
All right. Yeah.